Nowadays, if we want to make a cake, it's easy. We just have to go in the supermarket and buy some ingredients. But what about a few centuries ago? Of course, there were the chicken for the eggs and the apple trees for the fruits. But what about the flour? So just have a look in the past and a little flashback in the 19th century. Here we are in Atem near Zwolle in 1 hour in the north of Amsterdam. Behind me you can see one of the famous windmill in the Netherlands. The country count around more than 1,000 windmills. Last century they were usually used to produce flour and olive oil. Still today, every Saturday afternoon, this windmill produced also flour. Unfortunately today there is not too much wind, so it can't produce flour.
Depending on the direction of the wind, you have to move the entire top. We do that with this wheel and the chains that are attached to it, right?
Okay.
Now there is very little wind and we have to use all the four sails. On this plate the wings are mounted, so, right? If there is enough wind, then it starts turning. And this big wheel makes this axis turning also. And this big wheel with the teeth on it, it's the one that you see here turning over your head. If there is enough wind to grind wheat, then we pull this axis towards the big wheel and the teeth grip into those spokes here. You see? Those are the stones that are inside here and inside there. And you can see the grooves that are made into ways and in this one. The lower stone is fixed. It doesn't move. The upper stone is resting on a construction in this area. The grains are cracked, but are still being pushed outward until this area where the stones are almost touching each other. And here those cracked grains are pulverized into flour and the husks. What comes out from those big stones is collected in sacks, and here you can see the color of the husks and the white flour. If you want to separate those, you put it on something with a sieve on it. Here is the flour from which they make white bread. If you keep them together, this is a little bit more brown color. And those are mainly the husks.
Nowadays, we are not going in the windmill anymore in order to buy flour. But why not reactivate them and use again the windmill in the Netherlands? It could be a great idea to relaunch this trade and also to perpetuate the tradition only for the tourists.